Shetland's capital, takes its name from the Old Norse Lerwick, meaning muddy bay. Sheltered by Bresse, the natural harbour attracts a wide range of visiting craft. Lerwick became important relatively late in Shetland's history, building on the trade from the Dutch herring industry, and only became capital in the 17th century. From the scattering of huts and winding shoreline, which became Commercial Street, development was tightly packed into a patchwork of narrow lanes. In the 19th century, new docks to accommodate the fishing fleet were created to the north of the town. At Freefield, Hayes Dock was the centre of Shetland's fishing industry, and the largest ship built in Lerwick, the barque North Britain, took to the water here in 1836. The dock is now home to the Shetland Museum and Archives. By the late 19th century, the more prosperous citizens were moving from the old part of town to flatter land west of the hill head, and the town has continued to expand to become a thriving and welcoming place of around 7,600 people, serving all the 23,000 inhabitants of Shetland. Stone-flagged Commercial Street, the heart of the town, is the first port of call for most visitors. Winding between tall stone buildings, it gives a unique character to one of the finest small-town centres in Britain, and the hub of much of Shetland's social and business life. Above Commercial Street, the lanes have been rescued from earlier dereliction. As today's street signs acknowledge, the lanes were originally lawns and closes, but were renamed by the Commissioners of Police in 1845 to reflect personalities or themes of that time, hence Pitt, Reform and Fox Lanes. This is the Lodbury. It features as Inspector Jimmy Perris's house in the Shetland Detective series. Right on the water's edge, it looks very damp, but then that is how it's described in the book. There are little play areas scattered around Lerwick, which you come upon all of a sudden. I have to say, I think this looks a bit dangerous for little children. So steep. All over Lerwick, we keep coming across the name of Anderson, or Arthur Anderson. And he was a native of Lerwick, born at the end of the 18th century, and he became a Member of Parliament. He was also chairman of the Peninsula and Oriental Steam Navigation Company, which we now know as P&O. And through this, obviously, he was a philanthropist, and he left his legacy in buildings such as this one. We're walking around the Nab here. If it's right, we might see seals basking on the rocks, but there's none at the moment. The tide is rather high and it's quite cool. And sitting on the bench, we're looking across to Bresse. It was all very peaceful and still. We're looking across from the Nab to the Gilbert Bain Hospital, which featured in Island Medic on the television not so long ago. This is Cliquemin Brock. About 600 BC, Iron Age people built a house here, and a fortified tower was added later, and it's one of the major archaeological sites of Shetland. These little houses are built to a very similar design, with their hearth and their shelves around the hearth. Each one rather identical. No one quite knows the function of the brochs. Were they defensive? Were they accommodation, storage? But whatever, they had the two skins lining inside. You could climb up them, and they are a distinctive feature of the landscape in these islands. The Shetland Museum and Archives is located in the historic Hayes Dock. This new facility is an invaluable resource for both visitors and locals, introducing Shetland's story and provides a gateway to other local sites of interest.
Into these gigantic vessels, oil is pumped at up to 20,000.